To a championship edition of Tribe Sports Today presented by the Tribe Club. I'm your host, Andrew Phillips, and we're inside Kaplan Arena for this week's episode. We'll start fast with the cross-country programs who continued their dominance of the Colonial Athletic Association by picking up a pair of league titles this past weekend. On the men's side, William & Mary pushed its consecutive CAA title run to 15, the second longest active streak in the country, finishing ahead of Northeastern. Ryan Goose led the way for the green and gold with a runner-up finish. William & Mary placed five runners between 7th and 11th, with all five joining Goose on the all-CAA team. Finishing in order for the Tribe were Mac Haight, Ferris Sokola, Trevor Slight, Nathaniel Hermsmeyer, and Chris Hoyle. The women's cross-country program picked up its 20th CAA title, outdistancing league newcomer Elon behind a championship performance by Carolyn Hennessy. Reagan Rome, Megan McGovern, and Dylan Hassett all earned CAA honors, finishing 4th, 7th, and 8th, respectively. We'll now toss it over to my co-host, Laurel Jock, who's outside of William & Mary Hall.
Thanks, Andrew. Field hockey split its final two CAA matches, but secured a spot in the league tournament this weekend at Northeastern. On Friday, the Tribe scored five straight at Hofstra to down the Pride 5-3. Emma McCloy scored the game winner. Maria Pastor added a goal and an assist, and Emma Clifton dished out a pair of assists. In a winner-take-all situation for the CAA regular season title on Monday, the Tribe fell to number 18 Northeastern 4-2, despite a strong second-half surge. Navneet Singh and Aaron Mangus scored in the loss as William & Mary outshot Northeastern University 22-13. William & Mary will be the number 3 seed in the CAA tournament and will travel to Boston this weekend. The Tribe faces number 2 Delaware on Friday at 5 p.m. The CAA championship match is slated for 1 on Sunday. Women's swimming went 2-1 in the CAA pod meet with wins over UNCW and Delaware, while the men posted a perfect 2-0 mark with victories over the Seahawks and Blue Hens as well. It marked the men's first win over UNCW since 1989. Jamie Miller highlighted the Tribe women's effort, scoring the most points while picking up 5 wins, and Megan Howard posted 3 wins, including the 50 free. In total, the men won 26 of 34 races, led by Jeremiah O'Donnell, who set a pair of dual meet school records in winning the 200 and 400 IMs. Swimming is back in action this weekend at the Rec Center. Both programs face ACC foe Duke on Friday night, while the women's team hosts Richmond on Saturday afternoon. After a tough four-match road swing, volleyball returns to Kaplan Arena for its final two home matches of the 2014 campaign. William & Mary hosts Towson on Friday night before welcoming Delaware on Saturday evening. Both the men's and women's tennis team will wrap up the fall season this weekend. The men host the Tribe Invitational for the 9th straight season at the McCormick-Nagelson Tennis Center, with ODU, Penn State, Harvard, and William & Mary all competing. For the 8th time in the last 9 years, the women will close out the fall season at the Kitty Harrison Invitational hosted by the University of North Carolina. This is Laurel Jacques with Tribe Sports Today. Now back to Andrew with more on the Tribe.
Thanks, Laurel. The women's soccer team picked up a CAA quarterfinal victory, rallying back from an early deficit to beat Drexel 2-1 on Sunday. Sophomore Lisey Irvin scored shortly before halftime on a header, and senior Emery Camper provided the game winner in the 67th minute to give William & Mary its 12th win of the year. The Tribe travels to Boston, where it will face the league's regular season champion Northeastern in the CAA semifinals at 6 p.m. on Friday night. There will be live video of the semifinals on CAA TV. The CAA championship game will be televised regionally on the American Sports Network on Sunday. The Tribe football team suffered a tough 31-24 setback at James Madison on Saturday afternoon. Congratulations goes out to sophomore Kendall Anderson, who was named the CAA Special Teams Player of the Week for his blocked punt for a touchdown against the Dukes. William & Mary returns home to take on CAA newcomer Elon at 3:30 on Saturday afternoon at Zabel Stadium. The game will be televised regionally on Comcast Sportsnet. Check your local listings or back right here at tribeathletics.com later in the week for complete broadcast information. And finally, basketball season is fastly approaching, with both the men's and women's programs starting their seasons on November 14th. Don't forget to get your season tickets today by calling 757-221-3340 or visiting us on the web at tribeathletics.com. That'll wrap us up for this edition of Tribe Sports Today, presented by the Tribe Club. Make sure you follow us on all of our social media outlets, and be sure to stay tuned to tribeathletics.com for a big week as the CAA will announce a majority of its fall postseason teams, and we'll have you covered on all the CAA championships. For my co-host, Laurel Jock, I'm Andrew Phillips. We'll see you next time.
The Tribe Club, essential for excellence.